Good morning.
Ambassador Stennis, Mr. President.
Don, do you know?
Yes.
You know Don?
I do.
Good morning. The last time we met was at the Quai d'Orsay.
That's right.
How do you do?
Come in there.
Thank you.
You're going to have to chit-chat for a few minutes.
Press photographers come in and take our pictures.
All right.
My counterpart in the French Parliament, before he took up his presidency, worked on the summits of the
€5.
We were pleased to support your candidacy for it.
Thank you very much. In fact, you triggered it. I understand that correctly what happened at that time. It was a surprise to me.
Thank you.
You to become a common market.
Statement on our budget proposal. As you know, last week we met with our nation's governors and with state legislative leaders, timing and cost, and then they got around to financing. And part should be paid for the city, part for the county, they said, and part for the suburbs, and part for the state. The tough question was how much. We paid a steep price for years of good intentions badly misdirected. Families were generated and high taxes, all of which sent the economic growth into a tailspin. And local governments didn't escape the punishment. The compulsive spending had taken a heavy toll. It was almost as if some economic medicine man had the idea that since money could buy anything and federal programs could provide everything, that more money and more programs shifted power toward Washington, moved us away from the very principles that had kept our country on sound footing for most of our history. In the theory of local self-government. It has been dedicated by long practice to that wise and beneficent policy. It is the
did little more than put you in handcuffs. We knew that America could not move forward until local communities were back on their feet again. And that's why back in March of 1981, we asked for your support to embark on a new course. It's been 4 years, and we've begun well. But it's only a beginning. I believe that in lifting your communities toward a new era of lasting prosperity and stability, there are four keys to government closer to the people. We believe that when it comes to running county government, county officials will always do better from the county seat than bureaucrats could ever do from Washington.
We're still looking for ways to save you more. Now, the second key is to success is a revitalize public-private partnership, pooling our resources to harness the power and creativity of the marketplace for the benefit of all Americans. If only the Congress would give our enterprise zones and our youth employment opportunity wage bill a full hearing. We want hope and opportunity to reach every nook and cranny of our great land. And these initiatives deserve to
serves the people of our country. We really appreciate you taking your time to visit with us and to share with us your views on the important issues facing our nation.
Thank you, gentlemen.
good.
All right.
But it is very nice to see me. I'm here on a state business.
Mr. President,
you've been present. I mean, you've been in the White House. Some of the others have preceded you. I see occasionally when Carter and President Johnson. But,
President, the Ambassador of Iraq.
Well, I was afraid for a minute there. I knew you had your family.
Ambassador of New Zealand and Lady
Rowling.
Yes. How do you do, Mr.
President? I'm delighted to meet you.
Very pleasure to see you.
My wife.
How do you do?
How do you do, Mr. President?
Nice to see you.
Nice to be here.
You and I will go over and have a picture taken in front of the fireplace, and then you will come in and join us.
Oh, how nice.
Several countries over in your part of the world, and both New Zealand and Australia. And then, for some reason, I don't know why, at the last minute, the schedule had to be changed, timing-wise, I guess.
and we miss New Zealand.
Oh,
I've been looking forward to it.
I think you'll enjoy it very much.
I think so too.
Yeah,
I think
you'll. Perhaps it's not too late.
I think you found yourself very much at home in New Zealand. That's just, as we do, we have a very comfortable feeling.
Well, again, welcome.
Mr. President, thank you very much.
Thank you indeed.
Come in.
Welcome.
Great honor to meet you, Mr. President.
We're pleased to have you here.
It's great.
And Mrs. Palomo, who's the president of my
family. Nice to see you.
And daughter, Sarah.
How do you do? Nice to see you. Mr. Ambassador, you and I will go in front of the fireplace and have our picture taken, and then we will ask you to come in and join us for another picture.
Very kind.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Well, we should exchange our documents.
Well, these are my credentials and my letters of my predecessor, recall, and my remarks, Mr. Ambassador.
Well, the President. All right.
Thank it's a great honor much. To be here and be representing my country at this occasion.
We're very pleased, and we congratulate your country on its move toward more democracy.
We are having elections, as you know, on the 27th of October, and we are having a new president on the 14th of January. And my government, the government of Guatemala, is very happy to see what you are doing and your administration is doing for Latin America, and especially for Central America.
Well, I hope we can carry it through.
We certainly
we have a few problems with Nicaragua.
I know, and we have to solve them together.
Yes. All right. Won't you come in again? If you ladies get between us and make for your picture. All right. Well, welcome. I hope you'll be very happy.
Our salutations, please, to Mrs. Reagan.
Thank you.
And, again, we're looking forward to see it, that you have lots of exit on what you're doing for all of the world. It's an honor to meet you.
My honor.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank
you. Goodbye.
Ambassador Zimbabwe.
Mr. Ambassador.
Mr. President.
It's a pleasure to welcome you here.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Garwe.
How do you do?
My little daughter,
Paye.
And this is
what's
my big daughter.
How do you do? And you,
Mr.
Edmund G. Mr. Ambassador, you and I will go in front of the fireplace for a picture. And after we do that, then you will all come back and join us.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, very pleased.
Very pleased here to be here and to receive you very, very well welcome that I have received. And the weather has been beautiful, Mr. President, ever since I arrived.
I think they're talking about turning cooler tomorrow. Sorry to say, but I hope it doesn't. But well, we look forward to working with you. Most importantly, develop peace and prosperity in the African countries.
Thank you very much.
That wouldn't be a problem.
Thank you very much.
Now, would you all come in? And I think if we put them between us. Two individuals in front. There. If Mama lets them have them, they're candies called jelly beans.
Say thank you, Mary. Thank you. No, thank you, don't you? Thank you, Mr. President.
Goodbye.
Good luck.
You want here?
That's fine.
That was a good session.
Yeah.
All right.
Gentlemen, thank you all for coming down here. Pleased to have you all here, and the subject that's on our mind is, and I'm sure is on yours also, is arms control. And some of the people that are involved in this, I think it probably is important an arms control session coming up as we've ever had, because I think for the first time they are seeing things in a different light. And I don't mean by that that I think they've softened or changed their spots. I think they just see that it might be in their interest to join us up at this time. But I think it's also very important that we pick up an age-old and honored tradition in our country that when things go international, at the waterline, there are no Democrats or Republicans. There are only Americans. And that our negotiating team should be supported by the view of us as united, with no differences, determined with regard to this whole problem. And Jim, that's why, as I told you on the phone yesterday, I hope that there will be observers there, representatives, both sides.
Hello, Hale.
Hi, John, how are you?
Hi, good to see you.
How are you?
I'm pretty glad to see you. Glad to be here.
We don't want to make you feel unwelcome. No. We don't have a chair.
No, we take one. I like how this is a real treat and all this sunshine, too. Yes, Bill.
Yes.
Yes, Bill.
All right, Max, how are you?
Fine, sir.
Max, we'll put you right here.
Thank you.
Well,
round up.
Well, we got started talking out there, you know, and we got back into the old battle. You have a lawyer coming up.
Yes.
You know, you have a big battle coming up.
Yes.
And,
we were telling Senator Stennis about your comment this morning. Senator Stennis was one of those that first makes a call and say, should I go or not?
Yeah. I haven't had an appropriation bill then. We'd see each other every 2 or 3 days, and he just cut loose and called me down here. And I invited him to go.
Don't mind to see you, Mr. President.
See you.
I thought you'd have a green tie on today, that you're welcoming me for St. Patrick's Day.
Well, I got my
Boston College tie on. How are you?
Fine.
That's good.
Why don't you take that chair right over there, far end there?
All right, fine.
I'll take this one. Where's Don? He is? All right. Well, once now, take the one. This came from talking to the local newspaper announcers, yeah. Editors over there, the annual.
I have a press conference every day.
You do?
Oh, sure. I go up there every day. They don't print much about it, but I go up there every day. Hey, Don, how are you, old pal?
Mr. Speaker.
My neighbor from West Street in Cambridge.
Who was that?
That was you. Was that where you lived in West Street in Cambridge?
Yep.
Yeah. How are you?
We met in California, it was number four. 74
when
we were
here.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Four ways of photography.
You met Reagan?
Yes.
Рад очень встретиться с вами. Это
президент.
You do your answer and we don't want to.
Do you understand the Spanish part? Spanish, do you understand the language in Spanish? Like Los Angeles, you speak, I think anybody speaks.
I had been several years in television, and then there has to be a picture, which I should have said no.
Mr. President, if it's so easy for you all to meet under these friendly terms, why does it take so long and so hard to reach an arms agreement?
But now, you know I don't take questions from here, but I will answer just that to say it is a very complicated process. It is not just an easy thing that you can sit down and decide. There are many comparisons that have to be done. Relative strength in various ways.
What's your mood, sir, as you face the arms negotiations coming up Tuesday?
I think it's the beginning. I think it's the forward step.
Я хотел бы спросить о вашем настроении в преддверии женевских переговоров.
Среднее настроение.
Медиокр.
Медиум. Ну, ну, ну,
ну. Медиокр.
Медиум.
Медиум. Медиум. Так перевел.
Mr. President, would you be speaking about specific issues at Geneva in this meeting?
What's that?
Will you be speaking of specific issues at the Geneva talks in this meeting today?
We haven't had a chance to have any conversation yet. Imagine there will be some things of that kind.
Thank you.
Unfortunately,